And welcome to church today. It's a beautiful morning and I am so glad to be here with you. Are you excited to be here too? Yes, if you're excited, clap your hands. Yay! We are going to have so much fun today. But first, let us pray. Dear God, thank you for today. Thank you for our families. Thank you for loving us. Thank you because we can talk to you anytime. Help us to learn your word today in Jesus' name. Amen. Has he been there all along? Friends, do you know what animal this is? It's a lion! A lion. We're going to be learning about a man who was locked up with many lions. Yes, but first, let us go and sing and dance to God. Are you ready to sing and dance to God? Yes! Okay, come along!
I'm gonna run, run, run to his love, love, love. I'm gonna sing, sing, sing to God's Son. I'm gonna shout, shout, shout the name of Jesus. He is the one I trust. When I'm alone, when I'm afraid, I know that he is with me every day. He's by my side, he hears me when I pray. Jesus, I trust in him. I'm gonna run, run, run to his love, love, love. I'm gonna sing, sing, sing to God's Son. I'm gonna shout, shout, shout the name of Jesus. He is the watching over me. He keeps me safe. He loves my family. Jesus, I trust.
Welcome back, friends. Did you enjoy singing and dancing to God? Great, I did too. Okay, so friends, tell me, who do you enjoy talking to the most at home? Your mommy? Or your daddy? Or your sisters? Maybe your brothers? What about in school? Who do you enjoy talking to the most? Your teacher? Or your friends? What's your friend's name? I like talking to my sisters at home. So you see, friends, we enjoy talking to the people that we love. Do you know that you can also talk to God the same way you talk to your mommy and your daddy or your brother and your sister? Yes! We talked to him a few minutes ago when we prayed. When we pray, we talk to God and He listens. He hears us every time we come to Him. So today we are going to be learning about somebody in the Bible who also liked talking to God very much. Do you want to know his name? Yes, you want to know his name. His name was Daniel. Okay, so come along with me and let's go and see Daniel's story.
Stories of the Bible. Daniel in the Lion's Den. This is Daniel.
Oh, hey!
Who was a Jewish man who was taken to Babylon when he was very young.
Yeah.
Daniel loved God and followed God's rules. He talked to God 3 times a day and asked God for help often. Daniel served in the Babylonian king's court for many years.
Yeah, I know him.
And under many kings.
Hey, Daniel.
Daniel always proved himself to be more capable than all the other court officials.
I hear you. Thanks. Well, anytime.
Daniel was serving under King Darius, and because of his great abilities, the king made plans to place him in charge of the entire empire.
Wow, okay.
The other court officials searched for some fault in Daniel, but they couldn't find anything wrong with him. He was faithful, responsible, and completely trustworthy.
Wait!
The court officials realized the only way to get at Daniel would be to challenge his faith.
Come on!
So they went to King Darius.
Excuse me, Your Majesty.
And advised him to make a law that for the next 30 days, any person who prays to anyone except King Darius will be thrown into the lion's den.
I like it.
King Darius signed this law, and once a Babylonian king signed a law, it could not be overruled. When Daniel learned of this law, he went home and knelt down, as he always did, to pray in his room with the windows open towards Jerusalem. He prayed 3 times a day, just as he always had done, giving thanks to God and asking for his help. The officials went to Daniel's house and found him praying.
Gotcha!
They went to the king and reminded him of the law.
I remember.
Well...
Then they said that Daniel had been found praying to God 3 times a day.
What?
When the king heard this, he was very upset.
Get over here.
And he spent the whole day trying to think of a way to save Daniel.
Wait, what?
By that evening, the court officials came back to the king and reminded him that no law signed by the Babylonian king could be overruled. So at last, the king gave orders for Daniel to be thrown into the lion's den. The king said to him, "May your God, who you serve faithfully, rescue you." Then the lion's den was sealed shut with Daniel inside. The king spent the night fasting and couldn't sleep. Then very early in the morning, the king hurried to the lion's den. He called out,
"Hey Daniel!
Was your God able to rescue you from the lions?" And Daniel answered, "Long live the king! My God sent his angel to shut the lions' mouths so that they would not hurt me, for I have been found innocent in his sight." The king was overjoyed and ordered that Daniel be taken out of the lion's den. Then the king ordered the men who had schemed against Daniel to be thrown into the lion's den as punishment. Daniel was safe. There was not a scratch on him, for he trusted in God.
Welcome back, friends. Did you enjoy the story? I did. In the story, we saw Daniel in a town called Babylon. Can you say that? Babylon. Great job. And in Babylon, there was a new king. Do you remember the name of the king? Great! His name was King Darius. And King Darius loved Daniel very much because Daniel was a good and hard-working man. He always did what he was supposed to at the right time. Daniel also loved talking to God a lot. He talked to God 3 times a day. How many times? 3 times a day. In the morning, in the afternoon, and in the evening. But there were some friends who worked for King Darius that did not like Daniel. They were jealous of him. Do you know what they did? They went to meet King Darius and told him to make a rule that nobody should talk to God. Can you imagine? A rule that says you mustn't talk to your mommy or your daddy? No, that would be bad. But Daniel loved God too much. He could not stop talking to him. So he kept on talking to God in the morning, in the afternoon, and in the evening. And when these people that were jealous of Daniel saw him talking to God, what did they do? They went to report him to King Darius, and he was punished. How did they punish him? Did they ask him to kneel down? No. Did they ask him to close his eyes and face the wall? No. They threw him into a lion's den, a place where there were many lions. So the next morning, King Darius came to check on his friend Daniel to see if he was hurt. And to his surprise, nothing had happened to Daniel. Yay! All through the night, while the lions tried to eat him, God sent angels to shut their mouths so they could not eat him. Yay! So you see, friends, when we follow God and we talk to him every time, he would keep us protected and safe. When can you talk to God? Anytime. You can talk to him like Daniel in the morning when you wake up, in the afternoon when you're in school or when you're playing, and in the night before you go to bed. So when can you talk to God? Anytime and always. Yay! So you see, friends, when you follow God like Daniel and talk to him every time, he will keep you safe and protected. So how can we follow God? By talking to him anytime. When can you talk to God? Anytime. In the morning, when you wake up, in the afternoon, when you are in school or when you are playing with your friends, and in the evening before you go to bed. Great! Friends, do you remember our memory verse? Ephesians 5:1. Great! Let us sing it together.
Hello, friends. It's good to have you here with me. Let's learn our memory verse together. Ready? Great. Ephesians 5 and 1. You are the children that God dearly loves. So follow his example. Great job. One more time. You are the children that God dearly loves. So follow his example. So let's sing it together. It's very simple. You are the children that God dearly loves. Loves. So follow, follow his example. Ephesians 5:1 says. Great job. We'll sing it one more time. Ready? You are the children that God dearly loves. Loves. So follow, follow his example. Ephesians 5, come on, sing. You are the children that God dearly loves. Loves. So follow, follow his example. Ephesians 5 and 1 says, you are the children that God dearly loves. Loves. So follow, follow his example. Ephesians 5 and 1 says, you are the children that God dearly loves. Loves. So follow, follow his example. Ephesians 5 and 1 says, great job.
Did you enjoy singing your memory verse? Yes, you did. Great. Let us sing a song.
I'll go. I'll follow you, God, I'll obey. Hey.
Welcome back, friends. Now let us remind ourselves of everything that we learned today. We learned about how Daniel followed God by talking to him regularly. How can you follow God? By talking to him anytime. When can you talk to God? Anytime. In the morning, in the afternoon, and in the evening. Bye, friends. Have a nice week and see you again next week.